medical radiation scientist is developing a breakthrough cellular targeted radiation therapy based on neutron capture for use in treating difficult cancer and those that do not respond to the standard radiation therapy, which include brain, head, neck, and melanoma. But what if we want to talk about how to measure the radiation dose or dose verification in treating cancer? Here we go, we call it a dosimeter. If you want to describe how a certain material can be said as a better candidate comparable to the established clinical dosimeter, we primarily need to investigate the optical performance and its characteristic. The idea of the present work is to obtain improved spatial resolution at high sensitivity, monitoring the neutron dose delivered from the neutron radiation source. In regard to the present interest, we recognize there to be a considerable potential for rare earth ions doped with silica glass, which can be used in radiation dosimetry, the latter underpinning safe and effective clinical applications. As one of the rare earth material, GD or gadolinium has properties that meet better medical neutron radiation dosimetry specification, with high thermal neutron cross-sectional absorption coefficient of about 254,000 bonds. Building upon these reasons, a novel neutron radiation dosimeter is fabricated using non-toxic soldier method based on the GD doped silica media. To assess and characterize the material, a server machine will be used in this research, for example, FTIR and Raman spectroscopy, photoluminescent and also UVV spectroscopy. The findings from the previous Raman band study have shown significant atomic structural changes in the glass matrix compared to the pure silica glass type. GD3+ ion doped with the silicate glass will cause more depolymerization of the SiO4 structure, resulting in the atom arrangement disorder. In the case of the PL spectroscopy, the optical properties reveal that the glass study has the potential to be useful as a narrow band source within the UV light relative to the visible light region. This is because the predominant emission in the intensity in the range of 300 to 400 nanometers is reported to increase to a certain mode of the GD3+ ion concentrations, but to decrease as a result of the quenching effect. To explain the particular influence of the GD ions on the glass networks lacks absorptions, UVV study offers in what wavelength that the material absorbs light the most. Intense blue shift can be observed as the GD amount increased between 200 to 400 nanometers. This shows that our material is intensely absorbed UV light. GD dopant is said to be network modified in glass. How? This is shown from the previous FTIR study, and it reveals that extrinsically defective host glass may cause more holes to be tricked within its non-binding oxygen NBO cross-sectional capture edges. Therefore, the very many highly favorable optical characteristics of the tailor-made GDs doped with silicate glass via soldier rod shows a good agreement of its optical properties. From the strong UV light absorption, the stability of the GD ion in absorbing neutron radiation due to its high neutron absorption relationship makes it a good candidate for an in vitro dosimetry, hence make it an appealing option for dosimetry measurements in a clinical radiotherapy setting.